What's going on, ladies and gentlemen? Your boy Cheesy Plays here, and I'm coming at you with...
with Nefarious Neff, with E3. Oh my god.
And Siglums.
Hello!
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 Hey!
And today, ladies and gentlemen, we'll be discussing the one and only event that has been on every gamer's mind this past week, which is E3. So, it's all out there, guys. Well, I mean, there's still more, but GamesCon and then, you know.
It's over. That's it. We're done.
Nintendo thingy, my bob. Towards the end of the... But for right now, this is our sandwich. We got the meat for our sandwich. Here we go.
Oh, yeah.
And
I'm excited, man.
Today.
I'm excited.
Today.
We're starting off with Bethesda.
So excited.
Alright. So who wants to start off with Bethesda?
Oh, wait. Don't you want to explain how this is going to work?
No, I don't want to explain it.
Alrighty, I'll just do it quickly. Ready? Alright, so basically, guys, since E3 just passed and all the press conferences are out there, we're going to knock them down one by one, and we're going to go kind of lining up the way the press conference went. So starting off on Sunday, we had Bethesda, and then we went to Tuesday, which was Xbox, EA, Ubisoft, PlayStation, and then today we actually just had, Nintendo, Square Enix, and then the PC Gaming Show, and we're going to follow it in that order, and we're going to start it off with Bethesda. Go ahead.
So basically, their first announcement was, I believe, Doom, right?
Yes, it was.
Was it Doom?
Yes,
it was Doom. Yeah, it was. They started off with a Doom trailer, which looked pretty good. I mean, you know, if you, like, really compare it to, like, the old one, it's like, holy shit, you know?
I was blown away by the multiplayer change. That was insane. The whole snap map thing?
Yeah.
That was fucking crazy.
I don't know, man. They came out pretty strong with that, too. I was like, whoa. What is going on? You know?
Yeah, I think it's the first game running on their... what?
On their own engine?
Yeah, like the ID Tech 6 engine.
Got it.
Looks pretty cool.
Looks solid, dude. Like, bravo, but, I tip my hat to them, you know? I've never really played the Doom games. I mean, I had one for my 3DO. I think it was my 3DO.
Jeez.
But I don't...
old.
I know, dude. 3DO. Dude, I heard E3 next year, bro. It's coming. The 3D 2016.
3DS.
It's coming next year. But, yeah, so I could have sworn it was Doom on my 3DO, and I remember my dad playing it, because he'd always play it with, like, his friends and stuff like that, and, like, you know, I was, like, a little, like, 7-8-year-old, and I'd always, like, pop my little head out of my room and, like, see the game, and I was just like, oh my god.
What's that?
Yeah. Like, on top of that, this might be said for a minority of the audience, but Doom has new modding tools. You know, the original Doom creation tools helped establish the tradition of modding and
the franchise.
With the new
itself.
Edition of the mods, you know, it'll bring a lot more content for the game.
Agreed.
I can't wait to see it, like, implemented in other games too. Like, that will be probably insane.
Yeah, I know. It's gonna be great. Oh, never mind. I just read that so all these mods are gonna be available for PC, Xbox, and PlayStation 4. So I take back my statement. The mods will be available for every single.
Oh, never mind. Got you. I mean, I don't know, man. They came out with Doom right away, and it was like, oh my god. And then, you know, I believe they followed up with Fallout 4 after?
I think it was the Elder Scrolls.
Yeah, the Elder Scrolls card game.
Oh, yeah, the Elder Scrolls Legends. Yeah, the card game. The Elder Scrolls card game, yeah.
Yeah.
Go ahead, Conchas. Take the floor, buddy.
Alright, well, Bethesda had announced Elder Scrolls card game, which is, I'm gonna guess, and I think this is what they said too, or what they kind of were implying, that it was basically their take on Hearthstone. It's gonna be free to play as well, and it's gonna basically be, I believe, most of the lore is gonna be about, like, their games, like, from Oblivion before, like, including Skyrim, I think. I don't know about Skyrim, actually. And yeah, that's basically it about it.
So you're gonna have like cards from like every one of their franchises, or just every one of the games
based
that
about
come out?
Lore. Like,
yeah,
cards
no, I
about
got
lore,
you.
Yeah.
Oh.
Are you gonna try it?
I'm gonna try it, yeah, because I really love the Elder Scrolls franchise, so I'm gonna try it out.
Confirmed, beta videos and early access videos from Conchas here, from Sigalums.
All right,
dude. If I can, dude,
I'll see you by Taco Bell.
I would fucking enjoy doing that.
Only on PS, only on PlayStation 4 exclusive.
Come in to GameCube.
Yeah, GameCube.
Dude, GameCube too. Next.
I mean, yeah, based off the trailer that they showed off, it looked really similar to Hearthstone, and I mean, it was just like frames of pictures of the heroes and stuff.
Yeah,
that was Hearthstone, dude.
But it looked very similar to Hearthstone, and as a like a card game avid player, I'm definitely gonna try it because I'm hooked on Hearthstone. So I'm definitely looking forward to another card game that I can play.
Confirmed, double players, Sigalums and Nefarious Neff here will bring you the first play content.
Road to Legend, already.
Huh? What happened?
All right.
Okay.
Moving on.
The next game, I'd say we leave it off to Andy because he's the one that's played Dishonored. So take it off.
All right. So basically, I love the first Dishonored. Personally, I like the way the gameplay mechanics work. I mean, I played Thief recently on my PS3, so I gotta say, like, Thief was a little more like sharpened, you know, if I can say that. But anyway, like, Dishonored, holy shit, dude. I love the game. And when I seen, now they have, well, they showed a female protagonist, and she was pretty fucking badass. Like, I'm not gonna lie. Her ability to, like, well, the same ability he had in the last game, but, like, the ability to, like, morph forward and, like, pull yourself to certain areas. Or basically, like, it's like teleporting, except, like, you're actually throwing, like, wire, not wire. Like, it's kind of, it's more like, oh, fuck, I don't know how to, like, explain it, but, like, basically, like, if you, like, throw this wire, right, and, like, let's just say, Doug, you're down the street, and I throw this wire at you, like, I teleport to where that wire ends, where I want it to end, do you get me?
Okay.
So, like, when they showed that mechanic, I was like, I remembered it, and then, like, they showed, like, some shadow type of mechanic, because the guy ends up pressing, like, a button, and the walls start caving in on her, and, like, out of nowhere, she just becomes, like, this shadow thingy. And I'm like, whoa, what the fuck's going on? Like, I didn't know what was going on. But, like, she was sipping through, like, the wall, you know, rather than, like, running. But, like, she looks like a total badass. I forgot her name, but she looks freaking awesome.
Emily
and then
Caldwin.
There you go.
I thought it was Corvo Atana. And I thought Emily was, like, the ghost character.
It says right here, protagonist Corvo Atana and his ward Emily Caldwin.
Yeah.
Yes.
That was right.
So, and then the cool part is at the end, I mean, I think they already confirmed this, that you'll be able to choose between her or the guy.
Yeah.
And they have the guy picking up the mask, and I was like, oh my god, it's in the water. That's where I left it. Because nice. That's spoiler alert. That's where I left it in the last game. But yeah, dude, I'm super excited for Dishonored 2, and like the way they presented it too. But the only thing that ruined it for me, so I know Bethesda had their thing on Sunday night. I went Saturday with my cousin because I requested that day off. I went to UC San Diego. My cousin graduated. So on and so forth. But basically, while I was, like, you know, checking my phone on Twitter, all these, like, links started popping up about Dishonored 2. And I was like, no, you guys are just, like, please. I want to wait till tomorrow. So when I look at, like, the Bethesda lineup, it really isn't much. But, like, it's stuff that I've been wanting personally, if that makes sense. I'm just happy that it's finally announced, if that makes sense, you know?
Yeah, it wasn't strong, but it was definitely potent.
Heck yeah, dude. And to be honest, I look forward to Dishonored 2. You'll be seeing that on the Virtualist channel here.
Thanks, sir.
Yeah, but I mean, you know, other than Dishonored 2, they also had, of course, one of the most anticipated games for E3, I think, from the gaming community standpoint, which is Fallout 4.
Battlecry
looks like a good game. Battlecry, I've seen the trailer before. like before the C3, I think it came out. It wasn't like first announced, but like when it was announced last year, I think. It was announced at Gamescom or something like that. But that should look pretty tight. I don't know what you guys think about it.
I don't know. I honestly didn't really pay attention too much after, like, I don't know. Yeah, I don't think I pay attention to Battlecry that much. I don't remember it, unfortunately. It didn't leave a
never heard of
thing in my brain. Is it like a first-person shooter, right? Or like a MOBA-esque game?
Yeah, it's like a MOBA.
Yeah. I don't know. I don't really find like a MOBA like that kind of entertaining. But it does look good. But I don't think it's something that I would try. Well, I mean, I would try it, but that's if I have extra money to spare.
Okay.
Doug?
Are we still talking about Battlecry?
It's up to you, man. You're the one either closing it or ending it.
I wanted to move on and talk a little bit more about Fallout 4.
Go for it.
Yes.
So they did release the release date, which is November 10th this year, surprisingly.
Amazing,
and they showed
man.
A little bit more of the game. They showed like some
amazing
type of crafting, and it looked cool, man.
I noticed, yeah. The crafting part of it looked really tight. It looked familiar,
yeah,
too.
Like, and people were complaining games about the graphics, but I think after they showed more of the gameplay, I think people forgot right away, you know, because I
like,
forgot
oh.
right away.
What were the graphics?
Yeah,
the gameplay
the
they showed off.
Like, I mean, the first trailer they showed, it wasn't like, oh my god. It was more like, finally, like they announced it. But I mean, yeah, I get what you're saying. But yeah, dude, I mean, I pre-ordered the goddamn Pip-Boy edition because I guess they announced it after. I don't remember them announcing it on the show floor.
I think it was.
But
like
I know
at
they
the
announced
end.
It at the end of it.
Yeah, I think they said at the end you can when you pre-order you get a Pip-Boy. No, I'm not sure.
Well, because usually, like, when they say, usually at, like, the end of conferences, they're like, and that's all, and then I just press X on my computer stuff. But, yeah, so they announced the Pip-Boy edition. It looks freaking awesome. It actually has, like, an actual Pip-Boy for you. So, and the best part about it is you're able to connect your phone to it. You'll be able to put your phone inside the Pip-Boy, and your phone will operate with the Pip-Boy, and you could, like, use it while you're playing the game as well. So, like, if you wanted to change, like, an armor piece, you could change it, like, right on your arm. How cool is that? That's fucking cool.
I can just imagine how many phone batteries are going to be dying that day.
Dude,
everyone's...
My phone battery could get murdered. I wouldn't care, man. My phone battery could die, and I'd be like, well, you know what? I changed my pants up, at least, all right? That's all that would matter. As long as I change my pen.
Yeah, and then one more
addition
that they
that's...
revealed off at the Microsoft conference was for Xbox One, the game is going to be compatible with PC mods, which is cool. Because I don't know if you've seen the Fallout 3 mods or New Vegas
awesome
mods. They are incredible.
Yeah, it's gonna run on the Windows 10, correct? It'll be compatible with Windows 10 for the mods. Right. Yeah, I look really cool. It really did. Like I
so
want.
So personally, I'm gonna get Fallout 4 for PC.
For mods or what?
Yeah, because it's a really big part of the game.
Yeah, I know. Modding on the game is important. But yeah, man, that was Bethesda, man. They came out pretty strong this year, and it was their first conference too. I think that's what. That's crazy. It's crazy to think
about. You're forgetting one game. We're forgetting one game.
I am not forgetting
the
one
Fallout
game.
Shelter.
The mobile game for Fallout. Unfortunately, I don't have any space in my phone, so I can't download it.
I tried it out. Oh,
it's
cool.
Pretty tight.
It looks interesting, to say the least.
Yeah, like...
It reminds me... It looks like something like Tiny Tower. Why?
Yeah, just throw away Clash of Clans. Don't even bother with that crap. And then just download Fallout Mobile. Fallout Shelter, sorry.
Wow, the claim.
I'm throwing a jab at Clash of Clans. I don't care, dude. Kill me.
Damn. Like that, Doug?
Reddit threads.
Yeah, Fallout Shelter is pretty cool. You basically just build your vault, and you allow people into your vault, establish your own vault,
so on and so forth. You can gather tools, blah, blah, blah. It's pretty cool. It's basically a tiny tower.
Oh, it is? All right.
Sims Mobile.
Ooh.
Yeah.
I'm so excited. But yeah, man, that was Bethesda. And that it was crazy, too, because, like, I don't think I've ever seen, like, any other company, like, go off the dates that are set, which is, like, you know, Monday, Tuesday, and, well, today's Tuesday. Oh, my God.
Wait, today's Tuesday?
I messed up early at the beginning. Yeah. I did, too. No, today is Wednesday. No, tomorrow's Wednesday. Oh, my God. I totally messed up, dude.
Yeah, tomorrow's Wednesday.
Yeah. So,
I know you did.
At the beginning, I know. At the beginning, I totally messed up the dates thing, because I said Bethesda came Monday night, and then Tuesday, and Wednesday. But anyway, yeah, Bethesda came on a Sunday night, which threw me off. But, I mean, it was their first conference. What do you guys think about their first conference?
Overall, it was really good.
I thought it was pretty solid.
Pretty solid work from Bethesda. We tip our hat to you, and we look forward to playing your game.